I'm going to go through the complete A to Z setup and walkthrough of GoHighLevel's AI chatbot. I will also show you how GoHighLevel's conversational AI chatbot can fully automate your sales and support. Okay, so that's your text messages, WhatsApp messages, Instagram DMs, Facebook DMs, website chat widget messages, all answered by AI. This will allow you or your clients to never have to answer a message ever again, saving you a ton of time and making you a lot of money. Let's jump right in. Okay, so in your GoHighLevel dashboard, you're going to come right down to AI agents, and this is where you're going to have access to both voice AI and conversational AI. The AI chatbot is conversational AI, so that's what we're going to be over. So what we're going to do is we're going to come right over to conversational AI, and we're just going to immediately get started. And you can go down to the settings and do this exact same thing, but it's faster here. And one of the reasons they did this is because this has become such a popular feature that they had to make it more prominent. So you're going to go right into conversational AI once you click this, and you're going to click create bot. Okay, so you're going to have three different options. Number one, general Q&A, appointment booking, then start from scratch, which is kind of both. And to be honest, you can make one bot that does both these. I have done that. It just won't work as well as it could if it was just focused on one. So we brought to a dashboard that looks just like this. So bot settings is just where you're going to set up the bot. Bot training is going to be where you're going to bring the data in so the chatbot knows what to say. Bot goals is going to be the personality and exactly what you want it to do. And then the dashboard is just going to be the analytics of the chatbot. We're going to go through all four of these right now, starting with bot settings. So the first thing you need to do is name your bot. Pick whatever name you want. We're just going to click Mary. Then you're going to pick the bot status. So right now we're going to leave this as off because we have not actually set this up, but suggestive is just going to be prompts that will be sent through a chat window. And then autopilot is what you want, which is just it doing its own thing automatically. This involves a lot of work, so you don't want that, but we're going to leave this now and we're going to come back to this. Then we're going to have your channels. So in here, this is where you will select where you want the chat bot. Okay. So if you click Facebook, it will now answer all Facebook messages. If you click Instagram, it will now answer all Instagram messages. Chat widget, live chat, WhatsApp, et cetera. You just click them on and it will immediately start answering messages. And to get rid of them, you just click these little X's and then it is done. So in order for these to work, you're gonna wanna make sure you have these already set up. So for Facebook and Instagram, you're gonna scroll right on down here to integrations and you're gonna come right in here and you're gonna click connect and it's gonna bring you onto your Facebook account where you will just click continue as whoever and then pick the pages you want and it will connect you immediately just like that. Then to connect SMS, you're gonna need a phone number. So you're gonna go into phone numbers, pick the phone number you want, then go to Trust Center and get it A2P verified by following these instructions right here so you can immediately send text messages. Then you'll do chat widget. So if you don't know what a chat widget is, it is this thing right here on a website. They're very handy where you can plug in a widget and just start chatting with an AI chatbot that is connected to the website so you can start closing leads like this. This super important if you want leads. Tons of people click these to, you know, ask questions. So you want to make sure that you configure this. And then in here, once you have that set up, you basically click these to make it on and live. And by the way, if you're wondering how to set this up, what you're going to do is you're going to come back here. Okay. You're going to go right into sites. You're going to come right into chat widget and you're going to click new. And you're gonna pick the chat, which I would do an all-in-one chat because it will be all of these combined. And then you just click those two and it will make it live. Again, full videos on this on my channel, but I do recommend you watch these because that way you'll be able to build this chat widget and have it plugged into me. And it's literally like 3 minutes to get this entire thing set up. And again, once you have this set up, all you have to do, you just come into conversational AI, go to your bot, and click these two on. It doesn't get any easier than that. And then to have WhatsApp live, you would just come into WhatsApp, you plug in your business WhatsApp, not a personal, and then from there, it will start answering WhatsApp messages. So that's how you can have all of these connected and have the AI chatbot answer all of your messages. So then down here, you're gonna put in your business name. So I'm just gonna put in demo, you put in whatever your business name is. Autopilot mode, which we're gonna turn on. This is the wait time. So how soon does it respond? Does this respond immediately? Does it respond after a bit? I would do 15 seconds. If it's immediately, it looks like an automation. And a lot of people actually don't like automations because it looks like it's just prompts, not an actual chatbot. So 15 seconds and you're golden, or five, just don't do two. Then you have maximum messages the bot can send in a conversation. So this is how many messages it can go back and forth. I recommend you have this either at 10 or 15. You don't want people or other AI robots spamming your AI robot. It wastes time and it costs you money. So leave that right there. Send bot to sleep when send a message manually or through a workflow. Say you wanted to hop in and say something. It will immediately put the bot to sleep for 2 hours, 2 minutes, 2 seconds, whatever you want. That way the AI chatbot stops and there's not two people talking to it. Then we have pricing. So the regular pricing is 0.02 per response. Extremely cheap. Or you can get AI employee, which is unlimited for all the AI features. If you don't have a ton of messages, I recommend just using what's already set up, which is the 0.02, because it's so much cheaper. So yeah, the AI chatbot is so cheap. Again, you can upsell your clients on this and make a ton of money. We're going to pricing later. Make sure you look over all this, make sure it looks good, you have everything set up. And once it looks good, you're then going to click save. So then we come into bot training. So this is where you want to put your website data. So say I was going to train it on this website. I would copy and paste this exact URL I have right here. I would come right in and I would click paste. And what this is going to do is this is going to go to this demo website, scrape the entire thing, get all of the data, and then be trained and know exactly what to say to the people depending on when they ask. So that's what are your hours, where is your location, all of that stuff. It'll know that. If you don't have a website, you can come right in to a Google Sheet or a Word doc. You can type everything out you want in here. So that's name, address, phone number, all of your business data. You can come in right here. You can click copy link. Then you would come right back in here, click this, click paste, paste your Google Sheet in there or whatever, get data, and then it's going to scrape that Google Sheet and then have the data. So that's if you don't have a website. And once you have both these, they will pop up under uploaded links. And then that way you can see everything it's trained on and you can plug in as many as you want. I recommend only up to 5, but from there, you'll have everything you need for the AI chatbot to be fully trained. So if the website doesn't have a Q&A, which is just questions and answers, you can come right in here and you can plug them in. So like, what are your hours? What are this? And you would just put in the question or the answer and then click save. But if you want to add these or basically have these plugged in based on training, what you can do is also have it automatically come through what's called AI feedback. So let's say we do, what are your hours? So you could do, what are your hours? And then the answer would be actually 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. And then you click train bot. So that is where you train your bots. Then we're going to move on to bot goals. This is where we're going to configure what your bot is trying to do, okay? The first thing is if you're confused on prompts at all and what these are, you can click this right here and it will take you to Go High Level's page and go over prompts. It's literally called AI Prompting 101 and give you all the details you need to know so you can understand prompts really well. So it's broken down into 3 sections, personality, intent, and additional information. So personality is how it functions. How does it talk? Are you human or not? Intent is what is it trying to do? Is it trying to book appointments, sell people? And additional information is just extra guardrails to keep it in. But these are already set up. So it already says, you are a bot for a business name, blah, 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 blah. And it already kind of has these set up. But what I like to do is use a prompt, but these oftentimes don't work super well. And I have a really simple prompt that I have already made for you that you can copy and paste. It'll be right down below this video, completely free. So you can plug it in and make this work much, much better. This way you can have a pre-built up prompt so you can save a ton of time and just get this set up immediately. So let me show you the prompt I'm talking about. And again, this is going to be right down below the video, but this is it. You have personality, intent, and additional information. And all you have to do is change what's in these little brackets here and then copy and paste it right back into here. This is the fastest way to get a basic AI chatbot. Now, if you have something that's really complicated, you're gonna have to do more than this. But for the most part, a lot of you guys just need to fill this out and your business will be good to go and immediately be able to start selling people ASAP. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start with personality. So you're just gonna come right in here and we're just going to change these things out right here. So we come right into tone. So what is the tone of the chatbot? So we would go, you are a happy chatbot named Mary. And you literally put in whatever you want, guys. It could be flamboyant, it could be angry, whatever. So you do, you are a happy chatbot named Mary designed to represent Ryan's Roofing. It's a demo account I made. Then you're going to do, your goal is to engage users with a pleasant vibe that reflects our brand's voice, making every interaction feel authentic. So the reason I have it this way is oftentimes with this regular bot, it's not enough. It just doesn't properly do it. And then the AI chatbot starts to sound a lot like an AI chatbot, which you can have, but it doesn't work as well. When you use this prompt, it gives it just a little more to sound like a human. And it's also so easy. It's already set up. You'll literally just do this. You will click copy and you will come right in here. You will highlight everything that's in here and you're just going to paste this right in here. Way easy, way simpler. That way you can configure this ASAP without fiddling around trying to figure out stuff. So we're then going to move on to intent. So your primary job is to answer questions for your audience, which is going to be the leads you're trying to sell, potential roofing leads, whatever your audience is or your client's audience. That way it immediately understands the avatar. This is so important because if you come back here, it doesn't have this. It just says your goal is to assist the customers with their queries. It doesn't know. This is why I made this prompt for you guys and took all the work away, is because I see this all the time. People keep these and then their AI chatbot doesn't really answer. It just kind of flounders and everyone looks stupid. You want to make sure it knows the avatar because it will also pull from other sources to be that much better. Then you do focus on answering leads questions while keeping the conversations lighthearted. Whatever you have, you just want to pick it and put it in. Then you plug it in. That way, it just knows exactly how you kind of want it to talk. Because trust me, when you say lighthearted, you say serious, the chatbot will do that exact thing. So then you have, if you don't know something, say, guys, this is really important because a lot of the time, if it doesn't know the answer, it'll just glitch out and people will be like, what is going on? You need some sort of fail safe. So if they ask a question like, what is the price of X, Y, and Z, and it really doesn't know, it will immediately figure out some way to give them an answer as opposed to BS them. So it will say, ask my manager and offer to send you free quote or whatever. This is really important because if you set this up properly and it has some really complicated questions that say it can't answer, you can trigger a workflow to then immediately notify you or the user here, the salesperson, to immediately take over the conversation. That way, it immediately sells everybody. Now, I don't think there isn't gonna be anything you can't answer, but just in case it asks for someone to show up on the property at 3 a.m. to do a quote, this will be able to deal with that. Then copy and paste, same thing. And again, guys, this is so important because so many people leave this just the way it is and it doesn't give the AI chatbot any context. Remember, robots are literal. They don't understand what you mean. They understand what you say. So you have to be very literal. This is for potential roofing clients. This is for potential hair salon leads. Whatever you're doing, you want to plug it in so it knows the avatar. Last but not least, additional information. So you would come right in here and you're just going to fill in the exact same thing. So here's what you need to know. Our business specializes in whatever you're doing. Really important, you're going to put your business location in here. So whatever your business location is, copy and paste. So 3540 White Hart Lane, whatever your business location is. And then key details for this, these are just the main things the business does. We only do metal roofs. And then we're just going to do, we don't do shingle roofs. So then you just put in whatever you want and then you're good to go. But make sure you have like the need to believes right there. And then you have when users ask about estimates, respond with blank. So this is a general guideline because they're going to have a whole bunch of other questions. But again, you want to have these respond with free estimate form. Whatever you're trying to do, you just need to sit down and like look at this and be like, okay, this is what my business or client has. Let me plug in the stuff. I don't own a roofing company, so I don't know. But whatever your business is, just go in and plug in what's in here. If this is, can we chat on the phone? Whatever the thing is that you don't want to do, or if someone says, give me pricing, and you're a business that doesn't do pricing, please put that in there. And then always aim to outcome, which is the main thing you want the bot to do. So is that booking? Is that answering questions? Or is that selling? Whatever it is, you put that last thing here. And again, you guys might be like, this is a bit redundant. Why is it kind of going over the same stuff as it goes before? It's because the AI chatbot needs to be super told what to do, especially the Go High Level chatbots. You have to get very narrow on what's going on. So make sure you fill in the blank there. Again, if you guys have any questions on this or you're confused, drop a comment down below. I answer super fast, or message me for free on Facebook or WhatsApp and you'll be good to go. So now that you know how to set up AI chatbots on Go High Level and you know how valuable they are, you then need to know how to sell and demo them. That's why I'm going to link a video. At the end of this video, it's going to pop up right on the screen after. It's going to show you how to have a killer AI demo to sell any service-based business owner on this. I even have a free snapshot in that video that you can plug in that will do all of the work already for you and help you sell way faster. So at the end of this video is going to pop up my AI demo video. Please watch it. It will make you money. So check out that AI video right now. Thanks for watching. Check it out.